Here's what they think about you.
Through early morning fog I see visions of the things to be, the pains that are withheld for me. I realize and I can see that suicide is painless. It brings on many changes, and I can take or leave it if I please. The game of life is hard to play. I'm gonna lose it anyway. The losing card I'll someday lay. So this is all I have to say. Changes, and I can take or leave it if I please. The sword of time will pierce our skins. It doesn't hurt when it begins, but as it works its way on in, the pain grows stronger. Watch it grin. Suicide is painless. It brings on many changes, and I can take or leave it if I please. A brave man once requested me to answer questions that are key. Is it to be or not to be? I replied, oh, why ask me?
Here's what they think about.
Suicide is painless. It brings on many changes. And I can take or leave it if I please. And you can do the same thing.
Yeah, so I get that a lot, you know? You think the first time I heard that shit was on YouTube, you know what I mean? In the 2010-15s and stuff like that. So, you know, why I address stuff like that, you know what I mean? If somebody's, you know, it goes back to, you know, being a small child, man. Look at my fucking pictures, bro. Look at my pictures.
Horrified because racism is glorified. Every time I drop another rhyme, it's like I die. But I return just like a never-ending sequel, continuing my never-ending quest to be unequal. In the eyes of the gods I dwell with, not the rest of the suckers I go to hell with. I'm stronger than I'm longer than I'm faster, not a weakling. Look deep into my eyes because they're filled with hate. Now my teacher says I gotta write an essay about history that was made in USA. But I'm not American, you're not American. The only real Americans are the Indians. No credit for being at first, but I got him.
Look at me when I was a little kid. You think that I knew when I was 11 or 12 years old? You think I knew when I was that age, right, that I had to ask permission to participate in some kind of a culture, you know? To, you know, what happened was I was listening to all that headbanger shit going on around me because I had two very distinct paths. I was around a lot of black folks, I was around and Puerto Ricans, and I was around some white folks. And a lot of it was entrenched in music because my father was a musician and he had a studio. So as a 5, 6, 7, 8-year-old kid, I had some cultural observations that I made. You heard that fucking depressing song that I played in the background, all those comments? Like, I know what was included in white culture, in Caucasian culture, better than a lot of my other hip-hop brethren do, because I'm in those rooms and I hear what's said when nobody that's non-Caucasian is in the room. You know what I mean? I weighed and judged as a kid. I always had this desire to be good, you know, even when I saw like my homeboys, like little kids, and they're killing bugs and stuff like that. You know, it sounds corny, you know, it sounds soft, but that shit bothered me. I always wanted to be good. You know, I had that something about it. It's just, I don't know if it was because I love my dad so much and he always kind of emphasized being good and doing the right thing and everything or what it is. But I honor my parents, man. I appreciate and I'm grateful for every single atom of my body, right, that they gave me. The thing that I think people get twisted is I made a choice that I did not dig that culture. I ran, like when I saw the difference, like I had a little kid, when I was a little kid, I had a homeboy that, you know, this white kid, he's in school, and man, he was showing me, he had an older brother, he's maybe like 16 or 17, he was maybe 8 or 9, this motherfucker's, I'm looking at the music, I'm looking at like the headbanger stuff, and the heavy metal, and the devil worship, and then some guy bites a head off a bat, they're worshiping Satan, the suicide, a whole bunch of suicide, mental, it seemed like a bunch of people, adults, as a little kid, I was like, these adults are crazy. They got fucking mental problems, man. And you know that whole culture was, you know, horror and all this devilish, literal devilishment. There's a lot to that in that musical culture at the time. You know, even listen to Guns N' Roses, "You're gonna die." You know, even the most popular radio-friendly shit had that aspect to it, like that self-destruction. I remember listening to some dude talking about there was gonna be this one artist. He's a white dude. He's gonna be, yeah, man. He's gonna kill himself on Halloween at the show. You know, when I started seeing what that was like and I had the access to black music and black culture so easily, like in my home, I ran, not walked to it. You know what I mean? And at that time, you know, nobody was telling me that, you know, I didn't know I was going to have to worry 10, 20, and 30 years later that it was going to be called cultural appropriation. So by the time that was even a thought in my mind, you know, it was already too late. You know, as a person, I'd already been hardened and formed, man. But as an adult, I don't like being a 40-something-year-old father and then being referred to with that term, because I honor and appreciate, you know, what black culture has given to me. Just like Malcolm when he hears it, all the memories, all these people that I felt did some shitty things to me, they were white folks, right? The people at the school when I had some you know, behavioral problems in like kindergarten, first grade. Who do you think they put me with when they took me from the mainstream class, right? Who did I spend my time with, right? At home, with the music, you know, the positivity and the strength. Like, I'm looking at all this fucking Ozzy Osbourne, all this heavy metal, you know, Satan-obsessed, you know, suicidal obsessed music. And then on the other side, I'm seeing like the friendly Fat Boys and Rakim and all these like and the empowering stuff like Run DMC and the energy that had. You think I'm gonna choose this shit? You know what I mean? Get labeled with this thing. I don't know if anybody's ashamed of themselves or not for using that word Wigger, but when you say that, what you realize what you're saying is, you're saying, hey, I notice that you're a white guy, or I classify you as a white guy, and you're either doing or saying or behaving or have some values or something that I associate with blacks. That's like a white, you know? That's what they're saying. They're saying the N-word when they say that. They're just putting a W there and taking away the N, right? So I don't know if that's like that's something that you find to be appropriate. You know what I mean? In any capacity. I don't even like saying the fucking word, and I've been having to wear it for 30 years, right? So a certain sense of entitlement that I see that exists in people that disgusts me and has ever since I was a little kid. Look at my goddamn pictures. It's a difference between like, hey, I'm gonna kill that guy, I wanna kill that guy, or hey, I wanna kill everyone and myself. And or you read in the paper, this white guy shot fucking everybody in the goddamn church and then himself. Along the way, who do you think the person looks like that's given me the bad news that even though I pay $1,400 a month for my health insurance, that I've got a list fucking this small of primary caregivers to pick for my children, right? You know, and I got to go to somebody that's, you know, classified as emergency care, and I'm paying a month out of pocket that much a month, right? Who do you think the person looks like when they're telling me that you know, despite the fact that even being pretty successful with my businesses, I'm still in an economic situation where I have to live in a goddamn 900-foot square foot apartment, you know, with my two kids, and you know, and on top of that, you'd better give me more tax money, you know what I mean? And then I got to look up and see Trump, right? You think that these things don't affect a person over a long period of time, or you don't notice it, you know, maybe if you're coming from that different perspective and you see these things from that perspective, like, hey, I gave you a warning about this power, this type of people and this power, and then you start seeing those things come to pass again and again and again and again. Certain sense, you know, certain sadness and sense of being lost, you know, that I could intuitively feel around some of the white folks around me. And you know, let me tell you something, man, if you're of the opinion that it's like the huge mass majority of white people that have these, you know, these feelings like they want to, you know, do things to, you know, to oppress other folks, it's not that as much as it's a smaller group towards the top. But then, you know, there's interests for thinking and feeling that way. There's a certain level of comfort. They make it real comfortable to kind of, you know, to be, you know, in the stream of white supremacy and kind of cooperating, going along. Even if you don't call it that or you really even see it as that, you know, there's a lot of elements to our country where that's what you're in line with unless you go up against the grain, right? And so there's a lot of white folks that are muted, I find, right? And if they're not muted and they start to wake up a little bit and see their environment and stuff, they may be, it's so late in their life at that time that what they do it is it's a kind of like an immature way. It, you know, comes in the form of these protests that don't work or these Facebook posts or things like that. All that darkness and all that stuff that you hear in that Caucasian song, all that stuff from all that, you know, I don't know, man. Look at the suicide rates, man. Look at the suicide rates. Look who's killing themselves, right? You look at the most, right? Look at look at the media. Who's in control of all this violent shit that's on TV? I know that we participated. We're Americans. It's been shoved down our throats since we were little. We've been raised in the devil of civilization. So of course a lot of it, especially the stuff that gives us pleasure, is going to stick with us longer than maybe we would have wanted it to if we had some kind of choice in the matter. You know? I don't like what the culture produces in general. Look, man, I love my father, I love my mother, I love a ton of other whites. It's not like an anti-white thing. What the culture produces in general, the things that are permitted in this culture, when I've traveled and I've seen it not permitted in others, when I've read about history where it was not permitted, the stuff that goes on and the feelings that produce in people. You go on Facebook, man, go on Twitter, look at the people are falling the hell apart from the inside out all over the country, you know? What's the mainstream civilization? What's the origin point? What's the birth record of the civilization that's produced these kind of results? If I lived around a whole bunch of Japanese Buddhists or, you know, who knows where I live, but you know what? I would have been running one way or the other. I would have been running away from this mainstream Caucasian culture because I knew it wasn't going to be able to fulfill me at my heart level. And that's not to say that I don't appreciate a lot of European or European American individuals that contributed a lot of great things to the culture, because I appreciate those things too. Come on, you're going to fucking tell me that you don't love goddamn Tom Cruise, or, you know, I don't know, man. You know what I'm saying, man. You know, I'm sure maybe you don't like Tom Cruise, but you like somebody else. My thing is that I accept the good things that come with this American culture, but there's definitely a foundation of it that's very sick. And you know, I was very fortunate to be in the proximity of people that also had that awareness that could help me develop that awareness more. So I knew where I was, who I was dealing with, and the best way to survive, man, in a way that's, you know, not just survival based. Anything that's led to anything good in my life, you know what I mean? A lot of the times the genesis of that, the origin point of it was the black culture that influenced me when I was in my formative years. And, you know, that's not something I'm ever going to forget. You know, so you can call me whatever you want, but I don't got to be what you want me to be, you know? Peace.